Now our next topic is a function. Function is a self contained block or the sub program which actually designed to perform a specific work. Okay, and when we design the function, this function we can call in our program and execute the whatever the desired output is done for using the code in the function. Function may be two type. One is a library function and the another is a user defined function. Library function is like that printf scanf. Printf actually work whatever we write in the printf statement that will be on come on the your output. Using the scanf function, you can easily take the value from the user or from the keyboard. So every function are doing some particular work. That function already done in your library, the header file. So header file include all the this function is a stdio.h, so standard input output header file. This output file the header file include this type of input output function. Okay, these are the library function. Now user defined function, suppose we are making the sum of two number. So when we are making the sum of two number, that time if user write the function for based on how to calculate the sum of two number. Okay, so we can use that function to our program, and without writing anything we can calculate the value of the adding value of the two number. So in this way user defined function actually work. So when user makes some function, that is called the user defined function. Now function, this is called the first thing is the function prototype. Prototype means how a function, the what are the parameters are there in between the function. This is a function prototype. So function prototype basically has a three part. One is a function definition, function declaration, and the function call. First part is the function declaration. What is your function? What you want to do for that function, and based on that your motto, you are writing the definition. Okay, and function call. Function call always will be in your main function, because in your main function you are calling that function and use that specific work on in your main function. Now see an example of the these three parameter. So function, here in function we are taking three argument means arguments we are taking the variable. Now in that case, int means the data type, then whatever your function name, and after that open bracket in close bracket we are taking the variable. How many variable we are taking? We can write the data type as well as the variable name, or we can write only the data type. And after the semicolon it is terminated. You have to terminate it with a semicolon before writing any line. So first one is the function declaration. Next part is the function definition. So function definition means, so based on your function declaration you are writing the function body or the function definition. So int function type 1, whatever the type, then the variable name, type 2 variable name, type 3 variable name, because in the function declaration we are taking three variable. After writing, we are writing the some local variable and statement and return type. This return value, actually we are giving this return value to our OS. Now the main part. In the main part, we just call the function, whatever the function is there. So function, and within the function we are making the argument list, and in this way the function call actually work. Means in the main function when you call any function, okay, so that function can do some specific work. That work actually done on the main function, and after executing the all function call, the ultimate result value it will give the output. So in this way, the three parameter we can declare. Now one more thing, these are the type of variable, the type of arguments. There is two type of arguments when you declare any function. There is two type of argument. One argument is a formal argument, another argument is the actual argument. Actual argument, when the function call occurred, in the function call part, whatever the variable we declare, that is your actual argument. That means that is your actual copy of your variable. We do not execute or do not perform any operation on the actual variable. We make a dummy variable and we perform all the operation on that part. So what are the dummy variable? In the function declaration part, when you declare the variable, that is your formal parameter. Means that is your dummy parameter or dummy argument. All operation performed on the dummy argument, and after the execution, we just put the value on your actual parameter. We do not harm your actual parameter. We can do only with your formal parameter. Now see, the argument of the function definition are known as the formal parameter. Okay, when the function called function get called, the calling function, then that is a called function call. Okay, so formal parameter, when it is actually work at the beginning of the function declaration, it actually created, and after the termination of the function, the formal parameter is terminated, and now the actual parameter, it will go throughout our program execution. So these are the basic concept of the